begin. You are the sunshine that lights my heart within. And I'm sure that you're an angel in disguise. Come take my hand and together we will ride.
On the wings of love, up and above the clouds, the only way to fly is on the wings of love. On the wings of love, only the two of us together fly.
The snow when a ray of sun is felt. And I'm crazy about you, baby, can't you see? I'd be so delighted if you would come with me.
On the wings of love, up and above the clouds, the only way to fly.
Mm-hmm. changes everything. Hands and faces, earth and sky. Love changes everything. How you live and how you die. Love can make the summer fly, or a night seem like a lifetime. Yes, love changes everything. Now I tremble at your name. Nothing in the world will ever be the same. Love changes everything. Days are longer, words mean more. Love changes everything. Pain is deeper than before. Love will turn your world around, and that world will last forever. Yes, love changes everything. Brings you glory, brings you shame. Nothing in the world will ever be the same. Why did I go back to see her?
Alex is born in the past.
Oh. lovers, our friends turn into lovers. When I make love to you,
what I want most to do is to get close to you tonight. I celebrate my love for you
specialty for the Mary, Joe, Gary, Leslie, Brooks, Sands and Janet Margaret clubs. We have looked forward to this day for some time and it now has come. And in this act of a marriage ceremony, we worship God. And in that worship, we sing to his praise the very first hymn on your hymn sheets. The hymn, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Tells us that unless the Lord builds the house, its builders will have toiled in vain. Our help is in the name of the Lord, maker of heaven and earth. My friends, we have come together today here in this church, this house of God, to celebrate Gary and Janet's marriage in the assurance that our Lord Jesus was himself at a wedding and his power was revealed there and all that he could show and display of that power. That wedding was in Cana in Galilee. Marriage is provided by God as part of his loving purpose for humanity since the beginning of creation. Jesus said the Creator made them from the beginning male and female, and for this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be made one with his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Marriage is enriched by God for all who have faith in the gospel. For through the saving grace of Christ and the renewal of the Holy Spirit, husband and wife can love one another as Christ loves them. Marriage is thus a gift and a calling of God, and is not to be undertaken lightly or from selfish motives, but with reverence and with dedication, with faith in Christ's power, and with awareness of the purposes for which marriage is appointed. And it is appointed that there may be lifelong companionship, comfort, and joy between husband and wife. It is appointed as a right and a proper setting for the full expression of physical love between man and woman. It is appointed for the ordering of family life, where children, who are also God's gifts to us, may enjoy the security of love and the heritage of faith. And it is appointed finally for the well-being of human society, which can be stable and happy only where the marriage bond is honoured and upheld. Gary and Janet, you have come here today to Ferngair and you seek to be joined in marriage, and I am required to ask you if you know any reason why you may not lawfully be married to each other, that you declare that reason now. And since no such reason has been declared, let us ask God's blessing on the union that we're about to perform. And let us all pray. Almighty Father, Lord of heaven and earth, we praise you for your goodness and for all your gifts. Your power created us, your Son redeemed us, your Spirit sets us free to love. We thank you for the richness and the variety of life, for the providence which guides us and directs us. We thank you for the happiness of deep relationships, the one with the other. Very especially today, we thank you for the great joy that Janet and Gary have found in one another. We ask that the love and the trust in which they enter this covenant of marriage may continue with them throughout their lives, as we thank you for that love and that trust. Give them your Spirit now, that the vows they make to one another in your presence may be the beginning of a true and a lifelong union. And we ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, who is the Lord of life, and for his sake. Amen. Will the congregation please stand? And now, as a seal of the vows you are about to make to each other, will you give each other the right hand? And Gary, will you repeat after me? I, Gary, take you, Janet, to be my wife.
I, Gary, take you, Janet, to be my wife.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
And before these witnesses.
And before these witnesses.
I promise.
I promise.
To be a loving.
To be a loving.
Faithful.
Faithful.
And loyal husband to you.
And loyal husband to you.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Janet, will you now repeat after me, please? I, Janet, take you, Gary, to be my husband.
I, Janet, take you, Gary.
In the presence of God. And before these witnesses. I promise. To be a loving. Faithful. And loyal wife to you. As long as we both shall live. And now, as a covenant into which you have entered, and a token of that covenant, these rings are given and received. By this very ancient sign of love, you take each other to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, for as long as you both shall live. And so, in the light of the love that has led you here, and in the light of the promises that you have made before God in this, his house, and before your family and friends, I now pronounce you to be husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And those whom God has joined together, no one must separate. And now, as a first act of your married life together, I invite you to receive God's blessing. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep. May you find the sunshine of his love upon you each day you live. And may his grace, his mercy, and his peace bless, preserve, and keep you both this day and forevermore. Amen. Will the congregation please be seated? And now just a few readings from Scripture, which are appropriate to this time. And the first one from the first letter of John in the New Testament, where the writer says this: "Dear friends, let us love one another, because love comes from God. Whoever loves is a child of God and knows God. God is love, and whoever lives in love lives in union with God, and God in union with them." And that tells us something about what you have done today together. But more than that, there are the words in the first letter of Corinthians in chapter 13, where Paul writes this: "I may be able to speak the languages of men and even of angels, but if I have no love, my speech is no more than a noisy gong or a clanging bell. Love is patient and kind. It's not jealous or conceited or proud. Love is not ill-mannered or selfish or irritable. Love does not keep a record of wrongs. It is always happy with truth. Love never gives up, and its faith, its hope, and its patience never fail, for love is eternal. There are three things which remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of them all is love." And finally, the words of Jesus. We've read from other writers in the New Testament, and now John in his Gospel writes the words that Jesus himself said. Jesus says, "I love you just as the Father loves me. Remain in my love, for if you obey my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have obeyed my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my command: love one another just as I love you." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I began to wonder for a wee while there when they were going to stop looking at each other. And when they were finally, I had nearly to prise their hands apart. But that's no bad thing, I suppose, when we're at a very special ceremony like this. I think you're now beginning to relax a wee bit. Just a wee bit. At this point in the order of proceedings in the Book of Common Order, which the Church of Scotland uses, the minister is asked to say a word or two to the couple. It is not a sermon, it's just a few lines that I will be saying to you. So you have been standing for quite a wee while, but just a few minutes more. It's a very special day. Not just that it's Glasgow Fair Friday. I mean, a lot of what, you'll never forget this. The fact that you're married in Glasgow Fair Friday is something you will never, ever forget. Because everybody knows Glasgow Fair Friday, and you have a sunny one for once. So that's, I hope, augurs well for your married life also. But you'll never forget it, Gary, because she'll never allow you to forget it. It could have been the 17th of September and she still wouldn't have allowed you to forget it. But whenever Glasgow Fair comes round, you will not think of holidays, you will think of how to spend your money on a present for your wife, because she'll remind you of that. But of course, husbands can do the same. It's not just the lady's prerogative, it is of the husband also. But here is something someone once wrote. And you listen to this, although I'll be talking to Gary at this point. A husband, this person wrote, a husband also has to love his wife as an equal human being just for being her. He has to be concerned for her as another human being, not solely in the way she thinks, or in the way he thinks she should be or could be, but in the way she is, in her activities, her hopes, and her dreams. And the husband certainly should not think of the wife simply as an extension of himself. Now, I ask you to listen to that, Janet, because all that's written after that is the same principles applied to life. So if you were listening, I think you were, your booty had stopped shaking a wee bit, so I think you were listening. I'm sure you would get something out of that. But right at the beginning of the service, we talked about a man leaving his father and his mother and being married, and this strange phrase, becoming one flesh, very old-fashioned phrase, and it's something we really can't understand too well. It's a strange thing that two people become one, and yet you have done that today because you now are one together, bound up as we've been singing, together in love. And yet you remain two separate people with all that you think and feel of yourselves at all times. So you're two into one. I would advise you not to think too deeply about it, or your mind will start to boggle, because it's a very deep thought in theology, I can assure you. The one thing to remember is this, that although you are one, you still are individuals, and you have the right to express yourself individually too, but never ever forget that you act together and stand shoulder to shoulder, and you face life with whatever it brings together as one, though you are still two individual people. We can't really understand these things, but I can tell you from my own experience, and I'm sure it will be echoed by many within this church, within the life of a married couple, though we cannot understand, we most certainly can experience it and live it, and live it in love together. And so may God bless you both richly in all the days and months and years that you have ahead as a husband and a wife. Let us pray. God, our gracious and our loving Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for today and for everything that this day means. We all have our individual thoughts. We all have our praise of you for all you do day by day. But we center now on Janet and on Gary, asking that the love which has been shown by them to each other may be continued in all the life ahead. We ask that the blessing which has been conferred on them in this, your house, will be their stay as the days come and go. They may know that a firm and a true and a sure foundation has been built here today, and that they, building further on that foundation, may know well your love for them and their love maturing and growing for each other. So bless them and all who surround them today, and continue them in your favour in all the days which lie ahead. And now, as one family in our Father's house, we say together the family prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now we sing the wedding hymn together, the second hymn in your sheets. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the works thy hand...
Thank you.
of the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain in your hearts this day and forevermore. Amen. Sign that, by the way. Just sign your normal signature, just in case you're worrying if you have enough. I'll worry if I've got enough ink in the pen. Right, that's us there. Right. You're all very quiet and nervous.
All right.
Right, Janet, you're signing as Clarkston this time, for the last time. Have a wee seat. She's needing a wee seat. Yeah, a wee feet or say needs a wee seat. Can you sign in there? Just blow your name, all right?
Janet, have an idea. You want an idea? Hurry up.
No, listen to her, Janet. In that line, just where it says signature.
Jim, you've got a name.
She's over it. It'll flow quite freely. Try it that way. All right. There's a fountain, there are wee bits up. There you go. Well done. That's just them trying to put you off. Well done. That's great. Right, Gary. Oh! See, what do you make of that? All right, can you sign it there? Just at your signature as well. You should really talk it up, you know.